One of the easiest ways to add healthy indulgence to any meal is cashew cream. It's one of my favorite vegan meal prep essentials that I always have in my fridge. In this video, I'll show you how to make a basic original cashew cream and then four different variations, including one for dessert. And then I'll also show you how you can use cashew cream in your everyday meal prep and cooking. I rely on cashew cream to replace ingredients like half and half or heavy cream or sour cream, or to make creamy dressings and sauces. And when you add a little extra flavor, like we're gonna do today, you really won't even miss the dairy. First things first, you do need to soak your cashews overnight or for 8 hours in cool water. Or if you forget or you don't have as much time, you can soak them in boiling water for 1 hour. And when you combine soaked cashews with a liquid such as water or plant-based milk, they get so creamy, and that's where all the indulgence comes in. You do need a powerful blender like a Vitamix or a food processor in order to make cashew cream, because a standard blender isn't going to be strong enough to pulverize those cashews. So basic cashew cream recipes have some water, but if you want to make it extra creamier, you could use plant-based milk instead. We start our cashew cream recipe by pouring the water into the blender and then our soaked cashews. We're also going to add a half teaspoon of sea salt. And the last ingredient you need for any kind of basic cashew cream is lemon juice or apple cider vinegar, but I prefer lemon juice. The acid helps neutralize the taste of cashews. Those are the four basic ingredients you need for any cashew cream: soaked cashews, water, salt, and lemon juice. But I like to add a little extra flavor with some other ingredients. First, we have some chopped raw garlic. It's gonna add that sharp, pungent bite, and some nutritional yeast for some extra cheesy, kind of rich umami flavors. As for the amount of liquid, for 1 cup of soaked cashews, anywhere between 1/2 cup and 1 cup is a good place. If you want it to be really thick, start with about 1/2 cup. And if you want it on the thinner side, like a dressing, you can use about 1 cup. This is kind of what you're looking for, this smooth, creamy texture. It takes about 2 minutes using a Vitamix, probably closer to 4 minutes using a food processor. You want to make sure that you let it blend long enough so you can pulverize all of those cashew bits. And if you wait until the end of the video, I'll show you how I use basic cashew cream to spice up my meal prep every week. That's our basic cashew cream recipe, but if you are looking to do more of a sour cream substitute, I recommend adding some apple cider vinegar because it has the right tanginess that you're looking for in sour cream. And now I'm going to show you how to make the four flavor variations for cashew cream. Our first flavor variation is a ginger sriracha cashew cream. You'll need fresh ginger, some sriracha, and a little bit of agave or sweetener of your choice to balance out the spiciness. I personally love really spicy food, so I use a lot of sriracha, but I recommend starting out slowly and adding more to taste. And like sriracha, I would use this cashew cream over any kind of Asian-inspired meal. We're gonna start our ginger sriracha cashew cream the same way we do all of them, with some water. We're also gonna add, again, our soaked cashews. We're using some fresh minced ginger, as well as some garlic, nutritional yeast, sriracha, black pepper, also adding sea salt, adding a little bit less than usual because there is sodium in the sriracha. We're also using lime juice instead of the traditional lemon juice to complement the Asian flavors in this cashew cream. And finally, some agave to balance out the spiciness. Blend that up for about 2 minutes, and keep in mind that cashew cream does thicken significantly as it rests and sits in the fridge. Just tasted it, it's really good, but I like things spicy, so I'm gonna add a little more sriracha. If you're sensitive to spice, use less sriracha. Our next flavor variation is a rosemary miso mustard. We're gonna make a rosemary-infused olive oil. It's gonna be really fragrant, along with some miso paste, which is gonna add a lot of umami, and some spicy brown mustard. This is excellent over roasted vegetables or stirred into a creamy rice dish like risotto. For the rosemary-infused olive oil, we'll heat up some olive oil in a skillet, and once it's shimmering, you'll add several stalks of rosemary. You'll let that cook in the oil for a few minutes until it's really fragrant, and then we'll remove the rosemary and just use the oil. For the rosemary cashew cream, you need some water, soaked cashews, some mild yellow or white miso paste, our rosemary-infused olive oil, nutritional yeast, chopped garlic, slightly less than 1/2 teaspoon of sea salt because we do have some saltiness in the miso paste, and spicy brown mustard, but you could also use Dijon mustard. The miso paste and the rosemary infused olive oil together bring a really rich pop of umami to this cashew cream that is irresistible. Our next flavor is the cilantro lime cashew cream. So you'll need cilantro and lime, of course. We're also going to use some jalapeno peppers. It's going to be a little spicy, and some smoked paprika and cumin for those Latin inspired flavors. And I love using it over Latin inspired food. So a burrito bowl or a dip for a quesadilla, tacos, you name it. I do prefer mine on the spicy side, so I use two jalapeno peppers with the seeds, but for most palates, I'd recommend starting with one pepper. For our cilantro lime cashew cream, we're gonna start it the same way we did our original, with some water and cashews. We're also gonna add a half teaspoon of sea salt, as well as some cilantro leaves. We're also using nutritional yeast. We've also got some cumin and smoked paprika. And instead of the traditional lemon juice, we're gonna use lime juice and some black pepper. You want to make sure you taste it and see if it's got the right flavor you're looking for. This is really nice, but I feel like it could use a little more kick. So I'm going to add a little more cilantro, a little more jalapeno, maybe some more lime juice, and just kind of taste along the way. Finally, for our dessert cashew cream, it's a cinnamon vanilla flavor, and I'm using vanilla beans. If you don't have them, you can use vanilla extract. And I love serving it over fresh or dried fruit, or you can even use it as a filling for a raw dessert. For our cinnamon vanilla cashew cream, I'm using a whole vanilla bean. It adds so much lovely flavor. You're gonna split the vanilla bean in half and then scrape out the seeds. We're gonna start our dessert cashew cream with some plant-based milk. That's gonna make it extra creamy instead of using water. You can use almond milk, coconut milk, cashew milk if you really love cashews. And now we're gonna add some of the soaked cashews. Since this is a sweet cashew cream, we're not going to add ingredients like black pepper or nutritional yeast or garlic. We've got some ground cinnamon, our vanilla beans that have been scraped out of the pod, and finally some maple syrup. If you wanted to keep this free of added sugars, you could use dates instead, about 4 or 5 large medjool dates. With all of these recipes, you're gonna want to taste it and then adjust accordingly. I feel like this needs a little bit more maple syrup and a splash of lemon juice, but not as much lemon juice as you would for a savory one, just a little bit to balance the taste of the cashews. I already showed you how to use cashew cream in your recipes, but if you wanna see how I use it in the easiest vegan meal prep ever, you're gonna wanna watch this next video. I'll show you how you can use this one basic sauce and create 3 versatile, easy, and delicious vegan meals.